Some people don't last 25 days. They have lasted. And not only lasted, but they have profited. 25 years. 2 and 5 is 7. Signifies perfection. But 7 is also the platform where they launched at 8, which biblically signifies new beginnings. We are gathered together in the sight of God to witness for the second time this marriage and this union of Albert and Marie. The Apostle Paul commands that marriage is honorable, the bed is undefiled. Therefore, marriage should never be entered into ill-advisedly, but it should be entered into discreetly and in the fear of God. To this congregation, if anyone knows any just reason or cause why the two of these should not continue for another 25 years, you do now speak it, or hereafter forever hold your peace. And I assume by your silence there is none. To both Albert and Marie, in that great day when the secrets of all hearts shall be opened and the Lord shall reveal our thoughts, if the two of you know any just reason why you should not continue for an additional 25 years, you now speak it, or hereafter forever hold your peace. And I knew by your silence there was none.
Given and have
grace, brothers and sisters. They speak about the eternality. The circle of grace speaks about the eternality of the relationship that is never to be broken. It is never to be intruded into. Both gold and silver speak about the high polish that each of them shall give one to another as they matriculate through their married life. The gold represents that which is enduring and speaks about the power and the presence of their love one towards another. If you would again repeat after me, outward first, with this ring, I be wed.
I be wed.
And all my worldly goods.
All my worldly goods.
I be and thou.
I be and thou.
In Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen.
I, Marie, take the hour to be my wedded husband, to have and to hold from this day forward, for better or for worse. And with this ring, I give unto thee my love and my commitment and my support. In Jesus' name, amen. I'm going to ask that we would now stand as we pray over these vows that both outward and within have exchanged one towards another. Lead at the intercessors and those who are here are going to surround them. If you would grab somebody by the hand, I believe in connectivity. Appears to me now the day and time that we live in a society that we have a lot of connectivity, but we're disconnected. People would rather text the person next to them than just reach over and say, how are you doing? So oftentimes I require that we just grab hands to show a spirit of unity and harmony among people that profess that they love one another. In a day and time, we are witnessing that almost one in every two marriages result in divorce. What a refreshing example of commitment, love, and sacrifice that these two beautiful individuals have exemplified before all to see. Let us bow our heads as we go before the Lord in prayer. Dear kind and gracious Father, once again, we are grateful for the privilege you've given unto us to enter into your gates with thanksgiving and into your courts with praise. We give honor unto you and we bless your wonderful and your holy name. Father, as we come, we bow humbly and submissively to your divine and perfect will. As we bring this august body before you, as witnesses to the marriage vows of renewal of Albert and Marie, we unify our efforts, God, and we stand in agreement with them. That, Father, not only will they have experienced these 25 years, but 25 more. By the word of my mouth, I decree and I declare that it is done. I pray blessings, Father, as you deposit them under a continued open window in heaven. Pour them out blessings that they won't have room enough to receive. Keep their bodies from sickness, illness, and disease. God, keep them gainfully employed and never let them have lack or want in their lives. Continue to allow them to be examples to their children, their grandchildren, their great-grandchildren. Give them long life and satisfy them with your presence all the days of their lives. Most of all, God, keep your souls preserved from the rapture, that they can one day see thy face in peace. God, we thank you for their exampleship. And we ask that angels all the days of their lives will surround them and keep them and protect them from the hand of the enemy. And God, because we know you are faithful, because you are a faithful God, we commit them into your hands. And we thank you for the victories that you've already given to them by faith. These prayers and blessings we ask in the wonderful, the matchless, the incomparable, the majestic, the magnanimous name, the only name under heaven given among men whereby we must be saved. the name of Jesus. In Jesus' name. Amen. And amen. You can loose those hands and somebody put your hands.
Hallelujah!
Line is going to take place, but they'll make that known to you. Amen. So at this time, we'll all stand. Let's put our hands together.